Hey Arrows fans, joining us today is the director of Toronto Arrows Rugby, Mr. Chris Silverthorne himself. Chris, thank you for taking the time to sit down and answer some of our questions.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Anytime. Well, Chris, I want to start off with Lucas Rumble because last weekend he raked in his 22nd breakdown steal. And to put that in perspective for some of our fans, that is miles ahead of the guy coming in at second with only 9 breakdown steals. Chris, what makes Lucas such a dynamic flanker?
I think it's a few things. The first thing is the willingness to put his body on the line. He'll put his head in other places where a lot of players won't put it. He's got great timing as well. He just knows when and when not to compete for the ball. He's really picked that up over the years, and he's just a very flexible, a very durable individual that just really has no kind of fear for his body. Just puts his body on the line each and every week. So
I have to agree with you. And Chris, you know, speaking about Lucas Rumble and physicality, it brings to mind a very famous thing that Kieran Reid said on an interview that, you know, putting your body on the line shows how much you love the team and how much you love your teammates. And I guess Lucas Rumble loves to be an Arrow because he is one of the most physical players out there on the field at all times. Now, last week, we saw 9 players selected for the Canada tour of the UK later this summer. Chris, what would your message be to some of the players going abroad?
I think the message this week has been, this is a great opportunity and a great, it's just a great thing happening to these players. To represent your country is the greatest thing in our sport, and they all have embraced it, and it's just so appreciative of the moment, but don't take the moment for granted because you never know, this could be your last time, this could be your first time, but you got to take that moment, make the best of it every time you have the opportunity to put on the Canadian jersey. It is such a great honor to do.
I'm excited. I hope we can beat the English and the Welsh. And now coming to our last question, Chris, it's been a very long season. At this point, teams can have a lot of fatigue. They can be quite exhausted. How beneficial is it for the coaching staff to change the lineup, use rotations in these last stretch of games?
Yeah, I think actually we've had quite a few new players in. With all of these players leaving, we've had to kind of reload the team a bit. So having some new blood and some new fresh faces in has been actually uplifting this week. We've had a good week of practice. It's been a bit of a bounce to the step, more new players in, trying to impress. And then some of the guys that, you know, have been here for a long time, have had a better week of practice as well. They've really focused on getting themselves back in the game. So I'm hoping the new energy from the new players will bring a little lift to the remaining games of our season.
I can't agree with you more. I think having new faces just increases that competitive drive amongst the team. Thank you so much, Chris, for taking the time to answer our question. We wish you and the rest of the team best of luck against New York this weekend.
Thanks, guys. Cheers. All the best.